DJ Pj-roc, back at you with another country music reaction. Please subscribe to the channel. David Allan Coe, quite the controversial figure. We're going to be reacting to his song, If That Ain't Country. Let's check it out.
Here we go. Everybody know, I got that. I got that flow, flow.
The old man was covered with tattoos and scars. He got some in prison and others in bars. The rest he got working on old junk cars in the daytime. They look like tombstones in our yard, and I never seen him when he wasn't tired.
Okay. I love this minimalist approach with the guitar. Sounds kind of folksy to me. You guys let me know whether I'm spot on that or way off. So far, so good. Sounds like he's talking about his pops. Veteran, served. Lots of scars, tattoos, working on cars, bars, some drinking happening. Sounds like he was a mean guy, served some prison time, did that. So far, so good. Where's the controversy? Check out the rest of it.
He sold used parts to make ends meet, covered with grease from his head to his feet, cussing the sweat and the Texas heat and mosquitoes.
Man, Texas heat and mosquitoes.
And the neighbors said we live like hicks, but they brung their cars for Paul to fix anyhow. He was veteran proud, tried and true. He'd fought till his heart was black and blue. Didn't know how he'd made it through the hard times. He'd bought our house on a GI Bill, but it wasn't worth all he had to kill to get it.
Wow, war is hell. Bought the house with the GI Bill, but it wasn't worth all he had to kill to get it.
He drank Pearl in a can and Jack Daniels Black, chewed tobacco from a mail pouch sack, had an old dog that was trained to attack sometimes.
Sometimes.
He'd get drunk and mean as a rattlesnake, and there wasn't too much that he would take from a stranger. Now we're 13 kids and a bunch of dogs, house full of chickens and a yard full of hogs. I spent the summertime cutting up logs for the winter, trying like the devil to find the Lord, working like a nigger for my room and board.
There's the controversy. He said he was working like a nigger for his room and board. Well, he had to have been working pretty damn hard. Let's check the rest of this out.
Coal burning stove, no natural gas. If that ain't country, I'll kiss your ass. If that ain't country, it'll hair lift the Pope. If that ain't country, it's a damn good joke. I've seen the Grand Ole Opry, and I met Johnny Cash. If that ain't country, I'll kiss your ass. Mama sells eggs at a grocery store. My oldest sister's a first-rate whore. Dad says she can't come home anymore, and he means it. Ma just sits and keeps her silence. Sister, she left 'cause Dad got violent, and he knows it. Mama, she's old far beyond her time, from chopping tobacco, and I seen her crying when blood started flowing from her calloused hand, and it hurt me.
Well,
I mean, family drama. Who doesn't have some of that, right? Well, the storytelling here is, I think, really good. I like his unique approach. The structure of the song is not, what one would think of as conventional. But again, he doesn't seem like a conventional guy. Seems to top one. You know what I'm saying? It just gets better and better. Was there a movie?
She just keep working, trying to help the old man to the end of the one row and back again, like always. She's been through hell since Junior went to jail. When the lights go out, she ain't never failed to get down on her knees and pray because she loves him.
Yeah, mama. A recurring theme in all music, no matter what the genre. Mama, always there trying to make it right.
Told all the neighbors he was off in the war, fighting for freedom. He's good to the core and she's proud. Now our place was a graveyard for automobiles. At the end of the porch there was four stacks of wheels and tires for sale for a dollar or two, cash. There was 50 holes in an old tin roof. Me and my family was living proof. The people who forgot about poor white trash, and if that ain't country, I'll kiss your ass. That ain't country, it'll hurt if the pole. That ain't country, it's a damn good joke. I've seen the Grand Ole Opry, and I've met Johnny Cash. If that ain't country, I'll kiss your ass.
There's a lot to digest in this song, but I tell you what, I enjoyed this song. It was very different. That was the point, I guess. It was definitely unconventional. If that ain't country, I'll kiss your bleep. And yeah, the song makes sense in that. His point of view is, all of these things that he listed and sang about in some context represents country, represents a way of life in some respects. His voice is, man, he changes it up. I'm almost afraid to listen to some of his other stuff, so I've seen some of the titles. This one, I didn't have any issues with this song at all, as far as controversy. I enjoyed it. It was different, seemed long, but maybe that's just me. David Allan Coe, If It Ain't Country. If you're new here, please subscribe to the channel. We sit around and watch me listen to and watch country music, which is new to me. Thank you guys for being out there. I appreciate you. Until next time, peace.